Hey Rebel Rouser, I'm Alan Voivod, and this is Star Wars 7x7, your daily dose of Star Wars joy. And thank you so much for joining me for it. And thank you especially to the people who make this possible for you every single day with their support at patreon.com/sw7x7. So every month we have been pulling a card from the Star Wars Conversation Cards pack by Kelly Knox that was released by Inside Editions last year. This one that I pulled falls under the galaxy situation. And yeah, I gotta say, when I pulled it, I was like, I think I want to put this back and pull another one, but that just seems not quite on. So we're going to roll with the one we got, which is card number 108. The Dark Side Cave on Dagobah brings fears to life. What do you think you would see inside? And then the little booklet goes further and says, Dagobah's Cave of Evil is steeped in the dark side and it emanates coldness and death. When Luke Skywalker enters the cave, he faces one of his biggest fears, an apparition of Darth Vader. He fails the test by giving in to his fear and striking down the vision of the Sith Lord. So I'll tell you a couple of mine, and I'll even do it in a sort of time-bound way. When I was in my 30s, it was dying to the point where I was waking up and having panic attacks in the middle of the night about the possibility that I might fall asleep and not wake up. And thankfully that has subsided with a conscious and, you know, less so these days. But at the time it was definitely a more active practice of gratitude and appreciation for, you know, good things in my life. And that was able to, over time, calm me and help me, you know, calm my nervous system to the degree where I was able to have a good night's sleep. These days when it happens, it's a little bit of a different experience where I'm just able to say, well, if it happens, it happens, and I just have to focus on what I do with my day, assuming that my eyes pop open and it's one more day above the roses, as the song goes. The thing is, I've gotten older, it's not so much fear for my own safety as it is for fear of my family, for the wife and the kids. And yeah, that's, I think, the biggest fear, seeing something jeopardizing their health and safety, right? Like, that's the thing I think I fear most. And then airplanes. I will fly, and I, you know, I do it as often as is necessary and required, but I'm definitely not a fan, and you will probably see me on an airplane, if you ever see me on an airplane, at takeoff and landing with my eyes closed and, you know, going through a whole litany of superstitious things in my head to just keep myself calm. But yeah, those are the things that I think about when I think about the possibility of going into the Dagobah cave tree and, you know, thinking about fear. So that's that. But something else that I wanted to talk about today is the fact that this actually is 1 week before the official anniversary of the podcast, and it's the 10th anniversary of the podcast. And that's a place where there's been precious little fear. There's been nervousness prior to doing interviews and whatnot, but it's really been an absolute exercise in joy and love. And yeah, that's, I guess, my appreciation practice on a daily basis these days. It's appreciation for Star Wars and the galaxy far, far away that George Lucas has given us to play around in and to experience and to talk about and dissect, and handed it off to a lot of other creators now who are doing, yeah, you know, some are better than others and some appeal to other people more than others. I remember many years ago reading an article in Wired magazine talking about how there would never be an end to Star Wars at this point. And when it was with George Lucas, it seemed like, no, actually there might be an end to Star Wars once he was done with the movies. And then when he sold it to Disney and Disney said, hey, we're gonna ramp up the machine, yeah, that ushered us into the era where there would always be something new in the realm of Star Wars. As we talked about during the fireside chats earlier this month, it really is wonderful to be getting so much, but it is also getting, at least for me, a little overwhelming. And so I guess I'm starting to pick my spots, which is what a lot of Star Wars fans do. And ultimately, I think Lucasfilm and Disney behind them are trying to figure out what the right balance is on the scarcity front, particularly when it comes to live action, because that seems to be where it matters the most and where it manifests the most, basically, in terms of the quality of the product being put out. So yeah, when it comes to the future of Star Wars, I have very little in the way of fear, just the occasional nervousness of, are they gonna pull this off? And for the most part, they really have. So it's been comforting to see over the last 10 years. So that's what I've got for you on this episode of the podcast. And I would love to hear your answer to that particular question. If you want to share it, or if you want to, you know, share it about Star Wars specifically, then I'd love to find out what your answers are about that too. If you're catching this on YouTube, comments are right there on Spotify. The Q&A section should be there with the podcast. And anywhere else you're catching this episode, please head over to the blog post for the show's episode at sw7x7.com and let me know what you think. And that is going to do it for this episode of the podcast. If you enjoy the show, please help me get it out to more people who would like to get a daily dose of Star Wars joy in their lives. You can do that by goosing the algorithms with your ratings and reviews and likes and comments and subscribes and follows and joins. You can do that by just telling people yourself directly, either in person or online. And you can even help me as an independent creator produce this daily dose of Star Wars joy for the world to download and watch. And you can learn more about that at patreon.com/sw7x7. And it just remains for me to say thank you so much for joining me for this episode, as always. And may the Force be with you, wherever in the world you may be.
7x7 is not endorsed or sponsored yet by Lucasfilm Limited, Disney, or 20th Century Fox, and is intended for entertainment and information purposes only. Star Wars, the Star Wars logo, all names and pictures of Star Wars characters, vehicles, and any other Star Wars related items are registered trademarks and or copyrights of Lucasfilm Limited, or their respective trademark and copyright holders. May the Force be with them. All original content is copyrighted by Star Wars 7x7. We hope you love it.